Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Seth, and on my channel we kind of do a little bit of a mix of everything between exploring, car content, just family stuff, you know, with me and my daughter. But anyways, today's video is going to be getting my car prepped and ready for new seats, and also a harness bar and a harness, and it's a 2007 Honda Civic Si sedan. And I've already got one side out. This is what it looks like. Yeah. Got one side out already, but I wanted to make sure I knew how to do it first before I showed anybody, but we're going to start the other side here, and I'll show you guys how it's done in case you guys got the same vehicle or whatever and you want to get an idea on how to do it. There's not many videos online that are specific, so I'm going to go ahead and do that for you right now. But before we do, subscribe. Hit that bell so you get notified when I upload, and enjoy the video. Okay guys, first things first. You're going to want to get the seat up like that. Now you pop these plastic pieces off right here. Put those up there. You're not gonna need these where we're going. Pop those off. Now, let's see here. These freaking bugs out here in Georgia are horrible. Okay. So, it's going to be a 14 millimeter. And, here. Slide the seat up. Hold on. I recommend just getting them loose, that way you're not fighting with it on the front. Now it's got the same ones in the front. Slide the seat back like this. Not gonna be able to see this part, but there's two bolts in the front. Some have plastic pieces on it, some don't. Recommend getting a long extension like this. And I'm gonna break these bolts loose. Four bolts are loose, so you're gonna want to slide the seat back up. At this point, you can just take this, take these out. Now, you slide the seat back. You're gonna do the same thing with the front. After I get this out, you'll be able to see way better. Okay, that's third bolt. Okay, now slide the seat back up and be right back. Okay. under the seat, there's going to be some clips in the front. There's a nice bee right there. Get out of here, bee. Get out of here. It's a horsefly. Get out of here. Nobody wants you around. Okay, so under the seat now, you are going to have a few things to disconnect. You're going to want to... I forgot how to do this. Hold on. Okay. Disconnect that. And then you're going to want to disconnect... Actually, just pull these out. So there's this pin right here, this black pin. You want to pull that up and it pops right out. Okay. So it's going to be hard to get. So this tab right here, you want to kind of just pop this off, or you can pull it. Whatever. We're not using these where we're going anyways. So I'm just gonna pull it down and slide that off. Pull that through the seat. And we've got another pin here. I recommend doing this with the battery disconnected. I'm gonna have this one. It's gonna pull up, pull out, and it's done. Pull that out. Okay. Then from there, you should be able to just take the seat right out.
Okay, this leaves us to our next thing. You can, once you get the seat out, just pop this off.
Go, pop that off. Now there's gonna be another 14 millimeter bolt right there. Let me go grab my socket real quick. Okay, I went ahead, I got my 14 millimeter socket. What you're gonna do now is just take off this bolt. Just get it loose. Put the socket back on. Unscrew it by hand. Now don't lose these bolts, you might need them again. I would take it out, put that somewhere where you're not going to lose it. Okay, let me get this seat out of here and we'll continue. Okay. Now for this next part. Wow. Done a lot of change here. Oh, by the way, the bolts for the seats, I recommend putting them back in the holes. That way you don't confuse them or misplace them. That way you know where they are for when you do the next seat install. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Just put those in there loosely. And I am getting a new carpet for this car. That's also why I'm doing this. I'm taking my shoes off now. Okay, basically, get down like this. Now, I'm gonna pull your trim back just a little bit here. Okay, get that out of the way. And I'm gonna pop this off. If your headliner's in good condition, be careful, because you don't want to damage it, but mine's getting replaced. Anyways, do is pop that off. Pop these off. Okay. Pull this down. You also don't have to take this all the way off, so I'll show you over here. Okay. So you're gonna wanna remove this bolt right here. And you are also going to want to remove this 10 millimeter bolt right here. And then this one as well down here. It's a 14 also. Okay, can you see that? Right there.
Okay.
Once again, one of those little clips. Now there's gonna be this thing right here, just in case you need the original bolt. It's gonna hold this bolt in there. So just grab a pair of needle nose pliers and rip it right off. You're not gonna need that.
All right, guys, that's it.
You know, make sure you always put your bolts back in the holes. That way you don't lose them in case you do need them. Now I gotta vacuum out my car, and that's why I'm replacing the carpet right there, which is normal wear and tear for a 200,000 mile car. But now I can get in and do a good cleaning. It's gonna be a little bit, a few months before I get all the stuff that I need to do this. But if you guys will do me a favor and like the video, please share it. Watch the whole thing, it helps my video analytics. And you know, it's gonna be sick. I'm just gonna get some NRG seats for now. I'm gonna get the harness bar and a new carpet, and then the more you guys like, watch, and share this video, the sooner I'm gonna be able to get the things that I need to do this, and you guys can stay tuned to the next video.
I hope you guys enjoyed the video. There's not a lot of good detailed videos on this online, so I figured I would just make one. Yeah, with that said, thank you guys for watching, and until next time, peace out.